I'm Hari Sreenivasan. We're joined by Christine Mullen Kreamer from the National Museum of African Art. Thanks for being with us.
It's a pleasure.
You've got a new exhibit that's going to be running till December called The African Cosmos. What is it?
Yeah, African Cosmos Stellar Art is the first major exhibition and publication to really look at Africa's contributions to the history of knowledge, the knowledge about the heavens. Now that sounds kind of heavy, but really it's getting right to sort of a basic thing that we do the world over, which is look up at a beautiful starry night, make sense of the patterns we see in the night sky, bring some of those heavenly bodies down to earth as part of culture. And so this exhibition is really looking at the artistic response to that experience.
So what about students who are able to make the trip to DC? What are they likely to engage with or interact with? And then possibly for folks who can't make it to DC, what can they check out on your website?
Well, the website has a full sort of array of what's in the exhibit, various activities, so that I think visitors who can't make it will really enjoy what we have to offer there, lesson plans for teachers and so on. For visitors who come to the exhibit, first of all, I think they'll be wowed. There's a huge rainbow serpent created by the Benin contemporary artist Romuald Hazeme. Mm. And he's talking about that eternal cycle of exploitation using a symbol, which you find around the world, of the serpent eating its own tail. Mm-hmm. And it's called the rainbow serpent. So we're thinking, we're cueing that to the celestial phenomena of the rainbow. We have a wonderful painting by Owusu Nkoma that shows three figures and Adinkra symbols in the background. This is a graphic form of communication that's traditional in Ghana. But he's thinking about how celestial observation is both singular and a group activity. Like you and I might look at the same sky, but in fact, what we take away from that, what we're thinking about when we look at that, may be something that's quite different. A final fun thing, which you can do on the web and in the exhibition, is to actually listen to star sounds. Mm. Now, you might not think about it, but again, these celestial bodies put out waves, data, and that can be translated into an audio component, so you can actually hear the pulsating rhythms of the heavens above us. Interestingly, some of them actually sound like African drumming rhythms. It's this very unexpected connection. There's art-making activities in our hands-on education room. We have a summer and fall filled with activities. You can create your own constellation. We're going to have a star party. I think that's in October. And so we're doing all kinds of fun things connected with African Cosmos Stellar Arts.
Okay, and the exhibit runs through December, is that right?
It runs through December 9th, and you are warmly welcome, all of you.
All right, Ms. Kreamer, thanks so much for your time.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
I'm Hari Sreenivasan. Stay with us.